Hello again, Stephen. Lilley of Greencoat UK Wind joins us now in the Proactive Investor Studio here in London. A warm welcome to you, Stephen. Good to see you. So full year results out today. Walk us through the numbers. What can we see?
Yeah, so 2018 was a big year. We did quite a few things during the year. from the actual business that we run, the sort of core thing, I guess, is that the production was slightly below budget due to low wind speed, only 6% down. No great surprise there, all within the expectation. It happens. But power prices, a key component to our revenue stream, were above budget, therefore cash generation, £117 million, was precisely on budget. So of the core business that we run, bang on budget production. At the same time, then we've invested in four different wind farms throughout the year, so our capacity has grown to 836 megawatts. We invested £364 million in those four wind farms. We also entered commitments of £171 million to buy our first contract for difference project and our first subsidy-free project. Those will be coming on stream shortly. So the total of those are £540 million of investing, if you like, throughout the year. So important year in terms of investing. We've also in the year grown the gross assets to just slightly less than 1.9 billion and net asset value gone up to just shy of 1.4 billion. So a sizable year for us. Production basically bang on, cash generation basically bang on budget and quite a significant amount of investing. We also raised £119 million worth of equity in May. So you know, lots of things we did effectively. So a big year for us last year.
So very strong results there for the eco investor faithful, I suppose. Why would it be important for new investors to look at you?
We have a whole range of different investors in the fund. So we have some big institutions. We have a lot of retail investors as well. What we're predominantly trying to do is invest in a dividend that is increasing up with RPI every single year. So we started off in 2013 at 6p precisely. Every single year since then we've grown by RPI, so the target for 2019 is 6.94 pence. That's just the compounding of RPI. We've also at the same time tried to grow the net asset value on a real basis. So the 1.4 billion figure is actually 123.1 pence per share. And that since listing has been a growth of 25.6% versus RPI compounded to 14.8%. So we beat that, if you like, by 10%. So really the product is a very stable yield, increasing with RPI, but also having the net the capital, if you like, preserved on a real basis. So that product has been attractive, certainly in times of low gilt yields and yields more generally to a whole range of different people, but certainly for retail investors, certainly good for ISA investors. Obviously, the tax-free with a high yielding component, very very attractive for that, but also for institutional investors as well.
Important as well for all investors to note that your acquisition pipeline is chock-a-block as well. What have you got your eye on?
Yeah, well, we've got more than our eye on, if you like, because we've also since the end of the year invested in two new wind farms with SSC. So SSC was selling 49.9% of two new wind farms in Scotland. Stoneleg, just near Fort Augustus, if you know Scotland very well, it's just the south end of Loch Ness, and then Dunblaglass just near Inverness, actually. So we're buying just over 35.5% of that with a big pension fund coming alongside us. So we're owning that with SSC. It's our second big transaction, along with Clyde, which is the biggest wind farm in the country by generation, that we also own with SSC. So we're doing that. That will complete in about a month's time, £452 million. A large amount of money. It trips off the tongue by now, given we're a big company, more easily than it maybe have done in the past. So that's sort of, that's something that will come into the business in a month's time. We've raised some equity, so we raised £131 million a couple of weeks ago. That the shares were issued yesterday morning, so the market cap now is £1.7 billion. And actually with that, with Dunblaglass and Stoneleg in, we will be £2.3 billion worth of gross assets, which is obviously a sizable company. We own, we're the third biggest onshore wind farm company in the country after Scottish Power and SSE, so it's a sizable company now. And we see other opportunities coming down the line. We with those two investments, we will own 950 megawatts of capacity. That produces power for 900,000 homes. Birmingham is 650,000 homes, to give you a feel for the scale of the size of production.
And demand's increasing, of course.
Yeah. So we see the market as having about £50 billion worth of operating assets. We own 2.3 billion. So, you know, we're 4% and a bit of the market. So we think there's a lot of opportunity for us to grow. But we'll only do that if we see benefit to current shareholders.
Just lastly, if we can look at those opportunities to grow, and looking past a month's time and what's going to happen then, what sort of news flows can we expect to see coming from you over the next four quarters?
Well, I think that given we've also had a commitment to buy another wind farm just near Inverness, funnily enough, I think I'll be spending quite a lot of time in the Highlands, which is nice.
Nice and windy.
It's nice, yes, precisely. When that comes in the summer, that will take our leverage up to 38%. Now, we have a cap, self-imposed cap of 40%, because we're trying to give that very stable dividend and also have the net asset value protection and growth, in fact. So we're not trying to put lots of gearing on the business to try and shoot the lights out. We're just trying to, the yield is really important to investors. And so for us, we would expect, once we bought Tumline Clock in July, to be near that limit. So we would expect to be coming to the market with a prospectus at some point. That's just mathematics. You know, we have a limit, and when we're at 38, we're close to the limit. So we sort of anticipate that at some point. So that probably is news flow, if you like, and then the others will just be news flow of transactions that are completed effectively and come into business. So that's probably where it is. Coming on the back of that, I think we still see lots of opportunity. We think that there's a little bit of what we did at the end of last year was to try and combine the CFD, the contract for difference projects, which are fixed tariff effectively, along with subsidy free, which are obviously the power price in total, and try and put those together to produce a cash flow that's 50% fixed, 50% variable, which is precisely what the cash flow is that comes from our rock projects, all our current projects. So we think there's a bit of opportunity to do a bit of that on the side, but generally it's just a very big market full of secondary assets that are under the rock regime with the fixed and variable components in equal measure. So we think there's a lot of opportunity there, but we're going to be capped out on leverage shortly, or gearing shortly. So that's probably the bigger news that you'll see at some point.
Lots of interesting things happening for the moment, though. Stephen Lilley, thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.